Hello friends, once again I am here with a new lecture. As you know, I was presenting you a Java series, so that is going on. But in between that, whatever important topic I am feeling that is to be put on YouTube, I am recording my lecture and I am putting on YouTube through my videos. So today I am with some new lecture that is related to server side and client side scripting. Whenever I am asking this question to my classes, that what is server side scripting, what is client side scripting, then most of the students are replying that a script that is available at the client side, that is client side script, and script that is available at the server side, that is server side script. By some point of view this is okay, or whatever knowledge they are having, according to that they are answering, this is right, that client side script that is available at the client, okay, server side script that is available at the server. But I want to add my view, and or you can say that a correct view inside that, what exactly client side script and server side script. If we are categorizing that only on the basis of residence of the script or at what place that script is available, then practically both the scripts, client side script and server side scripts, are available at the server side when we implemented the complete website or a web application. So just I am switching my screen to my board, and then you can see it. So just see it here. So what is client side? And server side. Example of client side scripts, .html or JavaScript or you can say there are so many client side script, CSS, that is also one category that is executed at the client side. Or now you can say applet, that is not so popular today, but particularly if you are talking about Java, then VBScript. So such type of technologies you can say, or such type of scripts come in the category of client side script. Now what is server side? .asp.aspx or you can say .gsp. So today JavaScript is available for server side also. So such type of scripts, those are available at server. Now when we are implementing the whole concept, then everything will be available at server. So I am considering this is my server and I am considering this is my client. Now in which way they are communicating, they are request and response. Request and response, but in between that there will be processing. So after processing, server will be replying to client. Now if I am talking about different examples of this client side and server side, then web browser, this is my client, and server, in web browser, particularly Google Chrome. Google Chrome, IE, Mozilla, all are my clients. And what type of servers are possible there? You can see it here, like AWS, IIS, Tomcat, etc. So IIS and Tomcat or Apache, there are so many web servers are available there. With the help of that, we can execute, particularly for ASP, IIS is there. For ASPX, IIS with the special framework support. JSP can be executed on Tomcat. So in that way we are going. Now, as I told you about the diagram, this is my server, this is my client. Client may be web browser like Mozilla. Mozilla may be a client. Web server, I am considering IIS. Okay. Now, basically, I am taking one example of client side script, another example of server side script. So I am saying a.html and a.asp both are there. Just I am writing here bigger, a.html and a.asp both are available on server. So now tell me, on what basis you can say which one is server side script? So only on the base, which one is server side, which one is client side. So not only on the basis of residence of that, I can say this is client side or server side. Now, if it is requesting a.html, then completely a.html will be supplied without execution, no execution for that. Completely a.html will be supplied without processing. Now this a.html will be executed by Mozilla. Web browser is fully capable to execute a.html. So that is why it will be executed by web browser, not by web server. If client and server are there, client is requesting for a.asp, it will be replying after execution. So a.asp will be produced after execution. So only result will be given to a web browser, not a.asp code will be supplied. So first it will be executed by the web browser, and after that it will be given to it will be executed by web server, and after that the code will be, or whatever result is available, that will be given to web browser. In my next video I will be showing it practically to you, and I will be showing the code for that. So thank you friends, today I told you about the client side script and server side script. Only on the basis of residence of client side script like a.html and server side script like a.asp, I cannot say which one is server side, which one is client side. So I am categorizing that on the basis of execution. Who is executing? Web browser is fully capable to execute the client side script like a.html. So a.html is executed by web browser, and a.asp cannot be executed by web browser. So complete code will not be supplied by the server. Server is fully capable to execute a.asp. a.asp will be executed by the web server first, and this will be only the result will be supplied to web browser. So a.asp is server side script and a.html is client side script. So we are categorizing that on the basis of execution, which web browser or web server is able to execute that. So I think it is clear to you. If you have any doubt, then you can put that in comment section. I will be very happy to answer you. And you can like my video, you should like my video, you should share my video and subscribe my channel. I will be putting more and more engineering videos on it, so that your concept become clear. And if you have any doubt, then you can tell me in comment section. If you want any specific video on any specific topic, you can tell me in comment section. I will be preparing. Sure. Thank you.